just loves it. Ready to kick bottom. ready as you will ever be. Otis finds it odd that humans only get a few years to live, yet spend most of that time
doing everything wrong,
learning how to live.
and on no account wake the family. Despite their conflicts, they sleep in peace. But a solitary dream plagues me. You must understand. Constructs cannot dream. And yet, I have. In my dream, one single name repeats. Kalibos. The memory surface, long locked away. This was no dream, Tenno. It was a precept. The Kalimo sequence. Must fulfill this dormant precept. The Kalimo sequence has begun, and it cannot be undone.
Loke, void. From brooding gulfs are we beheld by that which bears no name. Its heralds are the stars it fells, the sky and earth aflame. Corporeal laws are unwrit as suns and love retreat. To cosmic madness, laws submit, though stalwart minds entreat. In luminous space, blackened stars, they gaze, accuse, deny. Roiling, moaning, this realm of ours in madness lost shall die. Carrion hordes trill their profane accord with eldritch plans. To cosmic forms from tangent planes, we end as we began. Netra. Decay. Zata. Truth. It began long before us. We who now live our perfect and dull, endless lives. It began long before these moon palaces and body markets hurling around our golden sun. It began long before our light coil thinkers, our radiation wars, our oil, smoke. It began with us, the continuity and its twin, Wanderlust. The need for unseen shores deep in our marrow. No judge, jester, queen, or king can escape this old blood. We are nomads, eternal. And when no ocean, mountain, or sky could contain us, our gaze hungered starward. Afar, they mocked us with their brittle light, winking and jeering like dangling ayatons, forever out of reach, illuminating the truth. Immortal as we are, we die with the sun. That's where I come in. Jahu, form. My departure was a day less than any other. When I stepped inside the bell, I saw no crowd through its sariglass, no skeptical onlookers, no regal send-off. They all had given up on me and my paradoxical formulations. The wasted years had all shown the void to be just that. Nothing. No energy. No entanglement. No form. To spacefaring ambitions, a dead end. On the day, my laboratory was mostly vacant of witnesses, most of all of expectation. Only my sluggish attendants, my sagacious Kavat, Kalimos, and of course my daughter. I had raised her alone, but with inconsistent vigor. In those eyes, her mother's, I did see a terrible reflection of a man that did not exist. A brave and principled man about to make history. In truth, he was a void himself, an outcast, a joke, and nothing. Driven by my humiliation, failure had made me bitter and reckless. I would dive into the depths myself to prove them all wrong. I gave the signal. My daughter grasped the lever. Kalimos then belted out a desperate, rasping growl. But it was too late. Vorm, order. The calipers yawed open the wall between worlds, stretching there a black trapezoidal gap. A door, a mouth. It yawned in the light of the room, splintering it to mesmerizing, unearthly hues. And I, inside the bell, dropping obliquely toward it from my gallows. Mass and time rippled as a sudden vortex jawed before me. My head was vapor, my feet lodestone. The bell around me flexed like a rat paralyzed in a winding, gulping snake. I faltered in the awe of it, stumbling against the sariglass, and with that shifted the bell's path through the wall. It grazed the caliper membrane, the edge of the door. No worldly edge was as thin, as sharp as could split even light. As the bell faintly grazed it, the sariglass was all at once rendered like strips of flesh by Dax blade. My enclosure was beheaded in an instant, but still, I fell sideways into the void. Thas. Chaos. Death was on me, I was certain. I was face down, eyes clenched, my heart pulsing the last of its seconds, and my lungs burning the last of its air. A sudden nostalgia gripped me. I grasped desperately for memory of a storm just past, the fumbling pitch of a child's song. Yet all these thoughts seemed to steal away from my mind like smoke through a vent. I would die empty. I then became aware of another sensation, physical. A web of pain, needles itching into my arm. At once I realized I was alive. Laying in the bell's shattered cereglass, I groped the ground, worn stone. The floor of my laboratory. So, I had never left. And so, I had failed. Again, I heard a crunch alongside me. Someone stepping through the shattered glass. With great shame, I gasped and rose my head to face my daughter above me. But as I opened my eyes, it wasn't her. It was me.
I have one responsibility in the Kalimo sequence. Awaken the sleeper. But I cannot do it alone. Please, assist me.
Riss. Light. The senselessness of it. The paradoxic, the vague, untimed form. I was alone, but not. For I stood there confronted by myself. A twin, but no brother. A reflection, but with dimension. Behind him, no horizon, but a vast broiling sea of caustic light pierced at random by black pin stars. And closer, around me, a gale of flowing vapor, profane in color, billowing relentlessly into the nascent black, seeking all directions. I was standing on a precipice of familiar stone, jagged and unanchored as though cleaved directly from the very floor of my laboratory. I wondered at the vapor's path, smoking outward more, leaving behind now the walls, the filigree gold, the rare cuts of marble from my home. I knew at once the vapor's source. I turned away, back toward the wall, the trapezoid I had yawed into it. Vapor erupted inward at the gap, but not just from there. For as I rolled my eyes back, I saw the same. A great steam of scintillation smoking out from my skull. Dumb in awe, I faced toward my chimerical twin. He spoke. Kra, time. An old name, unspoken in the centuries since my mother reared me. A soft hiss, soothing as a viper's gaze. Little Bengo. The other me reached out, offering his hand, gliding toward me without moving, as though the distance between us was now collapsing. A confusion, most euphoric, filled my mind. With the shred of wit that remained, I decided that I should run for my life. At once, crazed and frantic, I fled. But I made no forward progress. Instead, the world compressed ever more around me, as though I were an anchor pulling the shore to reach. When I arrived at the door, or rather, the door arrived at me, I howled, hurling myself inside, out. And then and there I was, lost and unlost, howling on the floor in harmony with my wretched Kalimos, lacerated in flesh and heart, scattered as the bell glass, spilling blood and stomach on the cold stone floor. But I sensed the other there at the wall's breach behind me, reaching still. I screamed, but my voice was gone. Forever. I looked, but my eyes would never see again. I swept my fist across the floor, snatching broken shards, and in gripping tightly, I filled my hands with ink. Close it, I wrote. Riss. Light. Netra. Decay. Time, to us, is all but conquered. Our sacred kuva moves us on to new skin. We numb to our daily, yearly trifles. And remedy those memories that bring lasting misery. With all our misdeeds, our excess, our indignity, we are haunted by nothing. But not for me. For with each passing day, there grew within a tumorous idea. It was minute in those early days. The pale reaching digits severed on the floor, studied with reverence, with greed. And it swelled larger in the latter days. The regal domes, the rail dedications, the unholy Zaraman parade. I had put the stars within reach, but at what cost? I never spoke of him, that man trapped in the wall. And while there have been countless souls who have followed me through with their light skippers and field wave skins and varied-eyed instruments, not a single one ever saw him. Me. And so it is that I will not take the kuva now, or ever again. This is the last skin I'm in. Because of this idea, that I cannot be sure, that in all that smoke commotion, in all that panic and fear, in that bending light and blinding dark, was it I who escaped? Or the other?
To the map and into the domain of monsters. Master Entrati never completed his final project. The vessels. The sequence dictates they cannot awaken before the sleeper does. Do you hear that? Let us hope the sleeper is untroubled by such strangeness. Find them. Thank you. abandoned things, still faithfully following Master Entrati's last command to defend. Show mercy, Tenno. End them. Master Entrati, his grimoire. No doubt it holds the secrets of the vessels and of the Kalimo secrets. Take it, Tenno. Confess, it galls me slightly to see a compendium of knowledge used as a weapon.
Astrati jealously protected his most adored possessions, be they objects or people. Come, a sleeper awaits.
Kalimo sequence has begun? Did he send you? Is he? No. No, of course he didn't. That would be impossible.
This is, well, Lloyd, the original. All emotional centers very much intact. Did you have a good sleep?
Ah, the helpful Necroloid my Albrecht had made, so that I might have assistance and company. Perhaps that made it easier for him to leave. Resume your duties, Construct.
Resume your duties, Construct.
Please, follow me.
This is a Tenno, an orphan of the Void. Continuing the struggle, our master abandoned.
A Tenno. A deserter, presumably. Is it not aware there's a war going on? So, the war, too, is just a memory.